What do the artists Billie Eilish, Lady Gaga, Kanye West, and Stevie Wonder all share in common? Sure, you might say that they're all successful artists, they're all famous and loved by general society, but in reality, what I'm referring to in this instance is that these musicians I just mentioned all have a similar condition called synesthesia.
Let's say the way that these pants feel, right? It's velvet, right? What if I wanted to write a song that sounded the way that this feels? Because I also have synesthesia, so I match everything with a color, with a number, with a day of the week, with a shape, with a, it's weird, it's weird. But so every time I create something, I'm already thinking, what color is it? What day of the week is it? What number is it?
Now, synesthesia is the mixture of the senses where certain perceptions become more blurred together. For instance, you might hear a certain musical note and then physically see a color flash in front of you. Or someone might say a certain word and that invokes a certain taste within your mouth. And if this sounds like something that you might have, well, it's possible because it's not that uncommon. Around 4% of the population have a form of synesthesia. And having synesthesia isn't bad, it's just a characteristic of who you are. Like having brown hair or green eyes, for example. And each form of synesthesia is different. For some people with synesthesia, their taste and their touch might be mixed together, and for others, their sight and their hearing might be mixed together. And for the remainder of this video, I'm going to be referring to the latter, where we see how different sounds appear visually to different people with synesthesia. It's a very interesting concept for non-synesthetes like myself to try and wrap my brain around. For example, Kanye West, who, as I've mentioned before, has synesthesia, said that the sound of the piano is blue, while bass lines are dark brown and purple, and that snares are white. Now, this isn't the same across the board with everyone who has synesthesia, but it is consistent within that person. For example, Kanye is always going to see white when he hears a snare. It's not going to be a different color. But if somebody else has the same form of synesthesia, they might hear a snare and then see the color blue. And that brings us to the topic of this video. And we're gonna look at how different synesthetes hear sound and interpret that into visuals. Take the art of Timothy B. Layden, a synesthete who paints the sounds that he hears. For instance, look at this painting. Now, I want you to try and imagine what sound he was hearing while he was painting this. It's very difficult if you don't have synesthesia, but I'm gonna play the audio clip that he was listening to while he painted this right now. It's very interesting to see how the brain interprets that sound into a very complex and beautiful image. Each of these paintings were made using different sound effects, seemingly put together, but still ended up creating a very beautiful painting. So for a non-synesthete, when I hear the wind blowing, I want to draw, say, like a tree with leaves falling out of the tree. But synesthetes see it more artistically and more powerfully than a non-synesthete would. And before I move on to the next artist, just take a listen to a couple more of his paintings and see what the art is supposed to sound like. So now that we've seen random sounds visualized into a very beautiful painting, that begs the question, what does music look like? And the artist Melissa S. McCracken has an answer. Melissa also has synesthesia, the one that blends sound and visuals together into one, and she paints her favorite songs and visualizes them as seen through the eyes of her synesthesia. So of the four options I list on the screen, which one of these do you think is the song that the artist has painted? If you said option B, then you are absolutely correct. This is Melissa's artistic depiction of the song Imagine by John Lennon. It's interesting to see how the elements in the paints all come together, and I wonder, looking at the painting, which colors represent the piano and which part represents the voice. We can also see texture in the paints too, where we see splatters all over, and that makes me wonder what sound that's supposed to represent, and what do all the shapes in the painting represent too. As someone who doesn't have synesthesia, I look at this painting and I'm trying to find where the start of the song is and where the end of it is. And there is somewhat of a line going through the painting, but I don't think this painting is simple enough to just show the start and finish from left to right. But rather, I feel like it's showing all of its combined elements all at once, all over the place. Let's take a look at the next painting. Of the four options listed on the screen, which song do you think this painting is supposed to depict? If you said A, Life on Mars, then you're correct. Again, we see different patterns in this painting compared to the last one, and it really makes me wonder, from Melissa's perspective, what styles of paint are used to paint classical music versus rock. It seems that with each painting, there's different colors and different shapes included, and given how with synesthesia, the person's perceptions of, well, the world around them is consistent, that means each time the artist hears the song Life on Mars, they're gonna see the same image. And that's really beautiful that people with synesthesia can actually visualize music in this way that most other people can't. So now I'm gonna do it the other way around. Take a listen to the next couple of songs and just try to imagine what the song would look like on a canvas. Let's start with Cello Suite No. 1 by Bach. Now, classical music seems to be very smooth and flowy, and in the painting, it seems to have that same sort of atmosphere, where in this one we see the colors slide down sort of like a waterfall, but more celestial in a sense. And the fact that synesthetes see these sort of things when they hear music just astonishes me. And it makes sense why a lot of successful musicians would have synesthesia, because that gives them another sensual output to view and revise their music. So while talking about classical music, what do you think the song Clair de Lune would look like? Would the song also be smooth and flowy like the last song we listened to, or would the paints be more jagged and all over the place? If you thought the latter, then you're correct. The paints in this painting seem to be more spread by a painting knife than an actual brush itself. And comparing these two classical songs visually, I sort of wonder why the first one looks all smooth and flowy, and this one has a sort of different feel to it. Sure, there are things in the background that have that smooth essence to it, but I still wonder what all the jagged paint in the foreground is supposed to depict. Is it the piano? Is it the tempo? Is it the volume of the piano? These sort of things can only really be understood if a synesthete explains them to us. I just find it so interesting to see my favorite songs depicted on a canvas, like Dear Prudence by the Beatles in this painting, or even the song Hallelujah by Jeff Buckley in this painting.
The minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing Hallelujah.
And even though I'm putting links in the description that explain synesthesia far better than I can, it's still nice having an artistic depiction showing us what synesthesia looks like for those that hear songs or sounds and can translate them into visual things. And looking at all these paintings are very beautiful as we see all the colors form together perfectly on a canvas. Another interesting thing that I noticed with this artist is that her paintings seem to depict that same nature that songs have, and it's that that nature of unity, where when you listen to a song and you hear all the sounds come together perfectly, it seems to show that same theme on the canvas where we see all the colors come together perfectly. And where hearing a song can be very satisfying, looking at these paintings are also very satisfying too. Although from person to person it's going to be different because everyone has different artistic tastes, but still, it's a very interesting topic to look into, and I'm putting links in the description to show the rest of these artist paintings as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. I know this video is shorter than the last few, but it's still a video, so you better enjoy it. I know this video was shorter than the last few, but then again, I didn't know what else to say because I don't necessarily understand this topic too much myself. But that won't stop me from appreciating this fine art. I hope you enjoyed watching, and stay tuned for further videos. See ya!